वन्दे वाञ्छित लाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दंपतिमिति ब्रूयाम उदाहो दंपति इति एक्चुअली लास्ट क्लास वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अंगज हाउ द वर्ड इट कुड मीन अंगात जायते एक्चुअली देर आर सेवरल मीनिंग्स फॉर द वर्ड अंगज इट नॉट ओनली मन्मथ इट ऑल्सो मीन्स रुधिर दट इज रक्तम एंड ऑल दैट सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड यू टेक वॉट द मीनिंग इट सेज But here it means Angaja is Manmatha. Okay, so we are in the description of how Indra started from his place, right? So Saha Kadachit Tarapathe Nirjagama. We are looking at that Gadya portion. We saw the Varnana of his elephant, the elephant on which he climbed, and then. The other one is Menaka and Ramba were all in their Adhyasita Charama Bhagaha. They were standing behind Indra. Now, he had Mahata Atapatrena Amboja Sambhavasya Animisha Drishti Srishtim Saphalayan. That is where the next one is. He also had Atapatra or Atapatra Trayate Iti Atapatraha, which is an umbrella. These are all the symbols of sovereignty. A Chakravarti is supposed to have Atapatram and a scepter in his hand, and all these things are Raja Chinhani. And this is one major Chinham, that Atapatram, and that's why he gives a lot of importance to that and describes it beautifully in this.
Guru Bhaga Chalada Laghu. लघु जंघ
जंघाल
जंघाल करी तुरग संघ जंघा जंघा
जव
जंघा जव द्रव द्रव द्रवद अमर भट कोटि समदर्श शिथिला समर सम समर्दर्शित दर्शि दर्शिथि ला इथिला
शिथिल हार मर्दन
शिथिल हार मर्दन जनित मुक्ता पराग संबंधादिव धवलीकृतेन ससंभ्रमव
वलत
ससंभ्रमव लब्धम
सो दैट यू हैव टू स्प्लिट दैट एज ससंभ्रम वलत अंबरचर
ससंभ्रम वलत अंबरचर नितंबिनी लोक चर
विकीर्यमाण
नितंबिनी लोक विकीर्यमाण मंदार कुसुम वृंदनिहि वृंद निःसरम सरम
मकरंद धारा
मकरंद धारा निरासा एव मुकुट 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 मुप मुपर्युपरि धार्यमानेन सर्वतः
दैट जस्ट पुट अ कमा There are actually two adjectives here. So everything will go, if you look at the end of that page, it says Mahata Atapatrena Saphalayan. So Mahata Atapatrena is in Tritiya Vibhakti, and all of the Tritiya Vibhakti are going to go and connect with that. So what is the first adjective that he says? Puro Bhaga Chalat Alaghu Jangala Kari Turaga Sangha Jangha Java Dravat Amarabhata. So it's one word, Sambandhat Iva Dhavali Kritena. The word here connecting Atapatram is Dhavali Krita. It is a white umbrella. Dhavali Krita. It has been rendered white by what? Now he is imagining what is the cause for it. There are many people who in front, there are elephants and horses running. And because the elephants and horses are running, the entire host of Amara, the Devas, are also running. So there is a stampede, Sammardha. In that stampede, the Devas are all wearing pearl necklaces. Those pearl necklaces are all falling down. And in that stampede, those pearl necklaces are being crushed by the feet of either the elephant or the horse or the people who are running. Now, these pearls being crushed, the pearl dust that comes, it goes and settles on the umbrella. Okay, so it settles on that umbrella, and this pearl dust has made that umbrella white. So that is this whole adjective is just that. So people are running, there is a stampede, pearl necklaces fall, and those pearls are being crushed. The pearl dust, as if the pearl dust has come into contact with the umbrella, and it has become white. Let's see word by word. Purobhaga in the front. Purobhage chalatu ye chalanti te. Alaghu jangala. Alaghu is laghu is very soft or small steps. Here alaghu is very fast steps. So alaghu, not fast. Guru is heavy steps. Laghu is light steps. This is not the measure of fast or slow. It is the measure of the weight with which they crush. That is how pearls can be crushed. If you are just lightly stepping on it like a ballet dancer, it's not going to get crushed. So alaghu, the heavy steps. So and they are running. So jangala kari turaga. Imagine kari and turaga, the elephants and horses, the host of elephants and horses, Kari Turaga Sangha, which is Jangala. Jangala is a very peculiar word. It means extremely fast. It's got a specific sutram for it. What it means is Jangala means Vegavat, that which is extremely fast. Not only fast, usually when you are fast, you are light-stepped, like a deer, but here it is not like that. It's a heavy steps. So alaghu jangala, gambhira jangala, vega or shigra kari turaga sangha. These things are running chalate. Now because of that, what happens? Jangha java dravat amara bhata. Jangha java, these amara bhata, the amara deva bhata warriors. So the divine warriors also are dravat, they are also running because of their jangha java. They have a very the speed in their jangha is calf muscles. So their calf muscles are also very they can run very fast. Very strong calf muscles, so they can run fast. Because of the speed that comes from their calf muscles, they are running. Dravati, who are running? Amara Bhata. How many soldiers are there? Koti. There are crores of soldiers, Deva soldiers, divine soldiers. Now, when they are running, there is a sammarda, there is a stampede. And because of that stampede, what happens? Shitila Hara. Hara, the necklaces that they are wearing are shithila. They become very loose and they fall down. When they fall down, those necklaces are being mardana, crushed. And from this crushing, janita, what happens? Mukta paraga, the pearl dust. Paraga means dust. So there arises a dust from these pearls which are being crushed from the stamping. Sammandhat, by the association of this, or owing to this association with the pearl dust, dhavali kritena atapatrena, the atapatra or the umbrella has been rendered white. That is your first adjective. Next, what happens? Where is it being held? Makutam upariupari dharyamanena. It is being held just near the makuta, Indra's crown. Now, what does it seem as if it is doing? So the next scene, he says, is there are many ladies who are throwing flowers on Indra. It's a Raja. Think of it. So the Raja is being worshipped, or they're all throwing flowers on him. When they are throwing flowers, there are droplets of nectar that can come from the flowers, because they are freshly taken flowers, plucked flowers. And there is nectar drops that can come from them. Now those nectar, when it falls on Indra, it will wet his head, no, or his makutam, it can destroy it. So it seems as if this umbrella is trying to stop that nectar flow from the flowers which are being thrown by the ladies. Okay, so sa sambhrama valathu nidambini jana. Sa sambhrama valathu, valathu also means chalathu. Those who are moving. So sa sambhrama na, we say that Tamil la paravarappoda apdiye odi vandu poo podranga. Now, the moment you see the Raja, you're just waiting for that. And then immediately there is a rush within the people and then they rush to put flowers, right? That is that sambhrama. Sambhrama is more of a rush that is there with the crowd. So rushing, they move forward. Who are they? Ambarachara. Those people who are moving in the sky. So they are throwing flowers from top. So Ambarachara, those who are roaming in the top, that is the Devas. And those, the Devas three, Nitambini is a three. Nitambini Loka, the host of ladies, they Vikiryamana, they are throwing, they are spreading all the flowers. What are those? Mandara Kusuma Vrinda, Mandara Pushpa. It's a type of flower. They are throwing bunches of that Mandara Pushpa. From those Pushpa, from those flowers, you have Nissaratu. Nissaratu, that which flows. What is flowing? Makaranda Dhara. Makaranda, honey. Or it is the, you can say, Makaranda is also pollen grains. Here, because he says Dhara, we can take it as honey or the nectar. The flow of nectar that comes from these flowers. What do they do? Nirasaya iva, in order to stop it or obstruct that flow that comes. This umbrella is being held on top of the makutam or the crown. Here, actually, upari upari means when you use upari as separate, you have to use it as makutasya upari. If you have done many sentence constructions, you will know that when you use upari, grihasya upari, utpitikayaha upari pustakam asti. So you use chashti vibhakti there. But here, if you notice, upari upari is used vipsa amreditam. That is, it is used twice, which means it is ati samipe ityartha or adho adho, adhyadi. These are the three words that can be used in double to indicate ati samipam. And when that they are used as a pair like that, then the word which is in Shashti Vibhakti has to be used in Dvitiya Vibhakti. It's a nice catch here. So, Makutam Upari Upari Dharyamanena. Not Upari Upari means you will feel as if it is held exactly on top of that Makutam. No, it's held very close on top of it. That's why the Vipsa is there. So, Makutam Upari Upari. Near on top of the crown, dharyamanena, it is being held. The atapatra. Okay, so two adjectives are done. Now, the third one. Sarvataha. Dharyamanena.
Dharyamanena. Dharyamanena. Dharyamanena. Sarvataha pralambha. ముక్తాసర కదంబ కదంబ శాలి శాలితయ సమంతతో నిహిత కృత నిహిత కృప్ కృప్ నిహిత కృప్ కుపితవా
కుపిత
నిహిత కుపిత విధున్ విధున్తు విధున్తు విధున్తుత విధున్తుత వికట అమృతధారా సహస్ర మండితేన మండలేనేవ శశాంకస్య సఫలయన్ అనిష్ట ఇనిమిష్ట దృష్టి సృష్టిం సృష్టిం భోజ సంభవస్య
అంభోజ సంభవస్య యా లెట్స్ దట్ అంటిల్ దట్ యు హావ్ ది ఆతపత్ర వర్ణనం So what is the third adjective that he gives? Sarvataha pralambha muktasara kadamba shalitaya. In that, you know, it's not just a plain umbrella. It has a lot of pearls hanging from everywhere. Okay. Sarvataha, on all sides, pralambha hanging. What is hanging? Muktasara, pearl necklaces or pearl strings of pearls. Kadamba means samuham. So, Muktasara Samuham, the group of pearl strings are all hanging, Shalitaya, because of that fact, because it is beautiful with all strings of pearl hanging everywhere, all sides. Samantataha, it looks as if it has been decorated, Manditena, with what? Shashankasya Mandalena, iva. As if Chandra Mandala, it has been decorated with Chandra Mandala. Now, another scene for us to imagine. What is he saying? You know that Rahu is supposed to, you know, in Purana, the eclipse is because Rahu tries to swallow the Chandran, right? So Rahu swallows the Chandran, and that is why we have the eclipse. So Vidhum Tuda here is Rahu. Vidhum Tudati or Pidayati iti Vidhum Tudaha Rahu. Now, he says, Rahu is very angry with Chandra and he goes to bite that Chandra. When he bites, he has very sharp teeth and he bites. Now, when he bites, what happens? The Amrita from the Chandran starts flowing. Amrita Dhara. Chandra Mandalam is supposed to have Amritam. That's why, you know, every time we see Chandran, the moment we see the moon and especially Purnima, we are very happy about it. Somehow it just fills our mind with happiness. Chandran also, if you look at Jyotisha, he is the graham for which controls the mind. So when people are very agitated, it's very good to go and look at a Purnima Chandra and just, you know, soak in that. That's why they say moonlight and all is like an Uddipana. It increases the feelings of love. It's more because he rules the mind. That's why. So here, Rahu, that's why they also say he is filled with Amrita Dhara. Now, when Rahu bites, there are holes. And from those holes, you have Amrita Dhara flowing. And that Amrita Dhara that flows, these strings of pearls look like the Amrita Dhara that comes out of the moon being bitten by Rahu, it seems. Samantataha, everywhere, Nihita Kupita Viduntuda. Nihita in the sense it has been kept. What has been kept? The Amrita Dhara Sahasra Manditena. It has been decorated by keeping the Amrita Dhara everywhere. Okay. So Nihita Vinyasta Kupita Rahu Vikata Danta Kshata. Oh, okay. The Nihitam goes to the Vivara. Nihitaha Vivaraha. It is an adjective to that. Vivara are the holes that are made. So, Nihita, that which has been kept. By what? So, Kupita Vituntuda, the angry Rahu, with his Vikata Danta Kshata, Vikata sharp Danta teeth, with that he has bitten Kshata. Vivara Kshat. So those holes that have been made by the sharp teeth of the angry Viduntuda Rahu, from those holes, Vivara Kshat, that which is flowing. What is flowing? Amrita Dhara. Amritam is flowing out of those holes. Sahasra Manditena. It has thousands of those Sahasra Dhara, Amrita Dhara, and it has been decorated with that. So it looks like as if Shashankasya Mandalena Iva. The entire umbrella looks like the moon, which is slowly the Rahu is being biting, and then the Amrita Dhara is flowing from the umbrella. You should imagine like that. So the umbrella is like one semicircle where it is like half of the moon and half of it has been bitten by the Rahu. Sarvataha Pralamba Muktasara Kadamba Shalitaya, Samantataha Nihita Kupita Viduntuda Vikata Dantakshata, Vivara Kshara Amrita Dhara Sahasra Manditena, Mandalena Iva Shashankasya. So Shashankasya Mandalena Iva Manditena. Mahata Atapatrena, a big umbrella, Atapatrena. With that, what does he do? Now this, he travels with this umbrella. He is Amboja Sambhavasya Animesha Drishti Srishtim Saphalayan. Brahma has created eyes for all the devas to be non-blinking, right? Animesha Drishti Srishti. He has created a drishti nayanam, which is animisham, which does not blink. Now, in order to make that creation a success, because you are constantly looking at something which just you're soaking in the sights there, right? So that means it is a success. That creation is a success. So because of this umbrella, which is so beautiful to look at, Amboja Sambhavasya, Amboja Sambhavaha is Brahma. Brahma's creation has become a success because of this Atapatra. Now, where does he go and connect it? See, he describes that Atapatra so much to say that the devas, all of the devas were looking at that Atapatram without blinking their eyes. So now Brahma can feel satisfied that he has created such a feature in the devas. Safalayanna animesha drishti srishtim amboja sambhavasya. Next.
Gandharva vadyamana bahuvidat bahuvida atodya ninada kabalikrita ashavakasha tayeya
avakashataya iva
avakashataya iva sakula chalita
sankula chalita
sankula chalita sena sankatonmukti simhasanadharapathe nirjagama tarapathe.
So nirjagama saha kadachit tarapathe nirjagama, in the path of the nakshatras. So tarapathe, actually tara and nakshatram are different. So tara is all stars are there, but nakshatra is only that 27 nakshatras which are Chandra's wives, right? Those are separate. So here tarapathe is generally in the akasha. So that akasha, he goes in that akasha, nirjagama he started. Now how is this patha, this margam? The margam, next is he describes the sound of that, where he says, now all the Gandharvas, Gandharva Kula Vadyamana, all the Gandharvas are all playing different types of music, different percussion instruments. Now that sound has completely occupied the space in the directions. Asha Avakasha Kabalikrita. Kabalikrita Asha Avakashataya. The entire directions, the space in the directions have all been swallowed by the Ninada, the sound that comes from Atodya, Bahuvida Atodya, the different types of percussion instruments that are being played, Vadyamana, by the Gandharva Kula. The host of Gandharvas are all playing different percussion instruments, and the sound that comes out has completely enveloped the space that is there. Now, what happens? When you fill a space with something, and in that space, this army is trying to move. So when the army is trying to move, it has no space there because the space has been filled up by the sound. Okay, this is all imagination. So if the space has been filled up by the sound and the army is trying to crush itself inside that space, it lets out. Imagine when you're being crushed into something, you let out a roar, right? As if you're unable to bear the, tolerate the pain. When you let out a sound, the sound that arises from the army looks like a simhanada, like a sound, a roar of a lion. So, avakashataya, asankula chalita sena sangha, sankata unmukta simhanada dharapate. Dharapate, the path towards the in the akasham. Simhanada dharapate. Simhanadasya dhara parampara. यस्मिन् पथे वर्तते यस्मिन् पथि वर्तते तादृशपथ पन्थाः. Now what happens is sankula means very fearsome, chalita, it keeps moving very fearsome. We saw that, right? Alaghu jangala, with heavy feet. So when they are trying to crush and move with a very fearsome gait, the sena sangha, the host of army, sankata, because of the dukkha that they are experiencing by trying to crush into the space which is filled with the sound. This is imagination, it is not true. So sankata, because of that pida that they experience, unmukta, they let out a roar, simhanada dhara, not just one roar and stop, but a dhara or a parampara, a series of sound that arises from the sena is like the roar of a lion. How does that come out? It is as if the entire space has been occupied and they don't have any space to move. तादृश पथे तारापथे निर्जगाम उ सः कदाचित् इन्द्रः. नौ नेक्स्ट् ही मूव्स् आन् टु, बिकास् ही मेन्शन्ड् दट् सिंहनाद, ही टाक्स् अबौट् द नाय्स् आर् द सौण्ड् दट् केम् औट् एट् दट् पायिण्ट् आफ् टैम्. इट् वास् मिक्स्ड् वित् दि आतोद्यम्. ही कनेक्ट्स् इट् ब्यूटिफुलि वित् द गद्यम् टु एक्स्प्लेन् इन् अ नैस् श्लोक. When he said Gandharva Kula Vadyamana Ninada and Sena Dhvani Simhanada, both of them when they are combined, he says in this shloka, it seems as if Nada Brahma Mayi Iva Nasira Seema. It seems as if the entire the border was as if it was filled with the Nada Brahma. Nada Brahma is like Atma Swarupa. You have, there are Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma. Parabrahma Swarupam is all, Shabda Brahma is equal to the Parabrahma Swarupam, because it is only through the Vak or Shabda that we understand the Atma Swarupam. So Shabda Brahmam is equal, that is the Nada Brahma. The sound or the ultimate reality as far as the sound goes is called the Nada Brahma. And it is as if the entire army's border is filled with that. And he imagines it like that. You read the shloka?
Near Kama.
Sindhurapadi, yeah. Padi Kriya?
Manjari. Kekar.
Yes. Manjiraihi.
Manjiraihi. Natana. नटना
नटना आर्भटी
आर्भटी मुखरितैः स्व स्वरवाम भ्रुवां मन्द्रस्निग्धरवैश्च किन्नरकरै किन्नरकर व्यापारितैः मर्दळैः श्लाघाश्लोकशतैश्च चारणगण क्रोद्गीयमानैः तदा नादब्रह्ममयीव तत्र रुचे
तत्र हरेः नासीरसीमा नादब्रह्ममयी इव रुरुचे. तत्र अन्द समयत्ल, दट् इस् अट् दट् पायिण्ट् आफ् टैम् इन् दट् एरिया वेर् हि स्टार्टेड् तारापथे तत्र अपिना तारापथे नासि हरेः नासीरसीमा इन्द्रास् नासीरसीमा. ऐ टोल्ड् यु अबौट् नासीर विच् इस् द सेनामुखम् usually the army follows the Nayaka, or the Lord goes in front, or the army follows. So there is one set of army which goes in front, which keeps saying the Jaya Gosham. That is called Nasira. Nasira Seema, Senayaha Seema, Nada Brahmamayi Iva Ruruche. Ruruche means Prakashate. It was shining like as if it was filled with Nada Brahma. How? Tada, at that point of time, because of all these things, there are three things that he mentions. We said, right, Nritya, Geeta, Vadya. These are the three things that form Natyam. He talks about all three of them. First, he talks about Nrityam, where he says, Manjirahi, Swarvara Vama Bhruvam Manjirahi. Swarvara, Stri, Vama Bhruva is beautiful eyebrows, so it is ladies. स्वर्वारस्त्रियः स्वर्गस्य ये वारस्त्रियः वर्तन्ते ते I keep missing up. Okay. Swarvara Vama Bhruvam Strinam Manjiraihi, the anklets, because of the sound that comes out of the anklets. That is the first one, Nrityam. Now, he gives an adjective for that Manjira, saying Natana Arbhati Mukarita. This Arbhati seems to be a very peculiar word. I don't know where he got that word from. I can't find it in any dictionary. I have tried to look at various places. In fact, Arbhati, the closest I could come was some Marathi word for Arabhati. Now, there are four types of vritti: Satvati, Arabhati, Kaushiki, Bharati. These are the four types of vrittis that are there in Kavyam, and it is also there in Natyam, where Satvati is a very soft form of poetry. Arabhati has a lot of samasa, and it has a very heavy rhythm to it. When you are describing, say, a forest, or if you are describing Nrisimha's avataram, then you will have to use words with force, right? So that sort of a vritti or a movement in a kavyam is called Arabhati. And whereas he uses the word Arbhati, which is more of a local word which has been used in Sanskritam. So I couldn't find. In the Vyakhyanam, he says Arbhati is Prakrama. That doesn't make more sense, makes any sense. I feel Arbhati should be a representative of Arabhati, a vritti, which is a more heavy style of dancing. Because they are dancing in front of a crowd, they can't softly do just abhinayam. No, that will not be effective in a crowd. So they have to use heavy form of dance, just like tandavam. So natana arbhati mukaritaihi. Because of the arbhati style of dancing, mukaritaihi, the anklets are making a lot of noise. And along with those anklet sounds, that is one thing. The next one is mandra snigdha ravaischa kinnara kara vyaparitaihi mardalaihi. So nrityam is over, next is vadyam. Mardalaihi, the madalam. Madalam is mridanga. Mridanga is being played by kinnara. Kinnara, again, kinpurusha or kinnara are who are all divya purusha. They're supposed to have half horse body or horse face, and nara is a purusha's body, that is kinnara. They sing very well. They have a very beautiful voice, and they also play different instruments. Now, kinnara kara, by the hands of, okay, kinnara kinnaraihi kinnaranam karaihi vyaparitaha vadyamanaha mardalaha. So the they play the mridangam, but how do they play? Mandra snigdharavaihi. You have to note the slight difference. Manda is soft, mandra is gambhira. Gambhira snigdha, very deep and loud ravaihi sounds. With the mardala sound is like that. It's got a very deep voice, very deep sound. So deep and loud voiced mardala, along with that sound. Next one is charanagana prodgiyamanaihi. Next is geetam. Here geetam is more based on shlagha shloka shataihi. They are singing hundreds of shlokas praising Indra, shlagha kirti. So praising Indra, the charanagana again are the type of gandharva. So the divya purusha. So the charana people are also prodgiyamana. They are singing hundreds of shlokas in praise of Indra. Because of the anklets, sound of anklets, mardala sound and the shloka sound, the entire border of that nasira, that is the sena mukham, seems as if it is filled with nada brahma. Okay. Next. Now, when the sound is all being described, there are people who are looking at Indra, right? Now, it's a very nice way to say this, where the people, you can gather wherever you want, right? Because Indra has 1,000 eyes. Imagine this scene. He has 1,000 eyes where he can see in front, he can see on the sides, he can see behind. Wherever you stand, you can see him also. Correct? So usually when we are looking at a person, the first thing we look at are the eyes. So which means the moment I see him, I didn't like him. In the sense, the eyes, there is something wrong with his eyesight. I don't like the attitude with the way he looks. So the eyes are very important to a person. It's like a window to the soul, you say, right? So people want, if they want to look at him or if they want him to look at them, then you have to look at the eyes. So eyes are very important. Now for, with Indra, he has thousands of eyes. No problem there. So agre paschat ubhayataha iti tyakta, let me read it. So agre paschat ubhayata iti tyakta lokavyavaste drishtyatasmin api parinate sarvata sammukhine sabhrubangam nayanavalanam sasmitam drashtukamaha bhuyopi agre sura paribridaha tasya punji babuho. So you can see him from wherever you want. Agre paschat ubhayataha iti drishtya, with his eyesight, he is beyond the loka vyavastha. Tyakta loka vyavastha. Loka vyavastha is what is the norm that is followed in the world. People have two eyes and there is only one range of eyesight. Right? If you go to a cow, maybe it has another range, 360 degrees, but it still cannot do 360 degrees bottom and all, right? Sarpa has on top of his head. If you take any type of, vriksha, even if you look at vriksha as jangama, as a chetana vastu, it can only see within that range. It can't see underneath its root and all. Correct? So here, Indra has eyes everywhere. So agre paschat ubhayataha iti loka vyavastha tyakta drishtihi. So drishtya, with his eyes, he has crossed the norm that is followed in the world. Tyakta loka vyavasthe tasmin sammukhine sati. Now when he is in front of you, then that person who has crossed or who is beyond the norm that is followed in the world, when that person Indra loka vyavaste parinate tasmin parinate ityukte samyukte, a person who is without any loka vyavastha, tadrisha indre sammukhine sati sarvadaha sammukhine sati. You can he is in front of you however you look at him. See, sarvataha sammukhine sati ityukte, see, when you are looking at a person, if you have to be abhimukha, if you have to be in front of a person, you have to be in front of his eyes. For Indra, you can be in front of him even if you are standing behind him, because of the presence of eyes everywhere. Huh? Sarvataha, all round, sammukhine sati, you are in front of him, abhimukhe sati, whether you are in front or back or on the sides. Tadrisha sthitau api. Now what happens? Tasya sabhrubangam nayana valanam bhuyaha drashtukamaha sura paribridaha agre punji babu. They all came and collected in front of him. Why? Because they wanted to see his eyes. Sabhrubangam sasmitam nayana valanam. They wanted to see those two eyes which have the brubanga with the eyebrows and with the smile. So that you can see only in the face. You cannot see with the other. He has only one mouth, no, to smile. He cannot, he doesn't have thousands of mouths to smile. So to see the different emotions that can be there on his face, they all assembled in front of him, it seems. So sabhru tasya indrasya sabhru bhangam, the knitting of the eyebrows or the play of the different eyebrows. You can express n number of emotions with a combination of the eyebrows and smita, mouth and the eyes together. But that can be seen only in the face. So sabhrubangam, along with the play of the eyebrows, sasmitam, with the smile, nayana valanam, the eyes. Valanam சலனம் வலது, வி சா தட் இன் த ஏர்லியர் பேராகிராஃப் ரைட். சோ நயன வலனம், நயன சலனம், பூயா திரஷ்டு காமாக, தே வாண்ட் டு சீ இட் அகேன், சுர பரிபிரடாக, தோஸ் ஹூ வாண்டட் டு சீ இட் அகேன், சுர பரிபிரடாக, த ஹோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தேவாஸ், அக்ரே அபி, தி கேம் அண்ட் புஞ்சி பபூவு, புஞ்சா இத்தியுக்தே ஹீப், தே ஆல் கேம் அண்ட் சரவுண்டட் ஹிம் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் டு சீ ஹிஸ் ஃபேஸ் வித் ஹிஸ் ஸ்மைல். It's as if they are describing Indra as Shiva. No? I am very curious to see how he will describe Shiva next. If he has spent so much of effort and beauty in just describing Indra, who is not at all the hero of the Kavyam, I'm very, very excited to see that Shiva's description. ఓకే సో అగ్రే పశ్చాత్ ఉభయత ఇది త్యక్త లోక వ్యవస్థే దృష్టి ఆదస్మిన్ అపి పరిణతే సర్వత సమ్ముఖీనే స భ్రూభంగం నయన వలనం సస్మితం దృష్టు కామాః భూయోప్యగ్రే సుర పరిబృడాస్తస్య పుంజీ బభూవుః. నౌ వి కమ్ టు ద మెయిన్ పార్ట్, ద శాపం విచ్ ఇన్స్టిగేటెడ్ ఆర్ స్టార్టెడ్ ద సముద్రమథనం. And for that, you have to describe who is the catalyst here, Durvasa. So one day as he was going, you know, sa kadachit nirjagama so gachanneva, as he was going, he saw Durvasaha. Now this is a big description again. Durvasasam nama tapasam adrakshit, everything is an adjective to him. And it is in Dvitiya Vibhakti. All of those that are in Dvitiya Vibhakti will go and connect with Durvasasam nama tapasam adrakshit. So go one by one.
Gachanneva sanabhasi bhasitava bhasitava kunchita sarvang sanga labdha parabhaga parabhaga basura
basuravihi
basuravihi abhi kyaya hridayam adhika adhikatala bahir నిర్గమిష్యతః కోపానలస్య జ్వాలా జ్వాలాభిర్వ పాట పాటలాభి పాటలాభిర్ జటాభిర్ అభిభవంతమివ తటిత్వ తటిత్వంతం అభినవం శారదాంబోధన్ శారదాంబోధన్.
We'll stop with that. So, gachanne eva saha. Gach saha gachanne. Nabhasi gachanne eva. As he was going in the nabhasi akashe gachanne. Durvasasam tapasam dadarsha. Kidrisham durvasasam. So, bhasita avakuntita sarvanga sanga. Now, jatabihi tatitva ambodam abhibavantam eva. He has jata in his head, right? So he has the matted hair. Now, what does he say here? He has applied bhasma on all of his body. Bhasita avakuntita sarvanga sanga avakuntita achadita. So bhasita is bhasma, vibhuti. He has avakuntita, he has covered sarvanga, all of his body with the bhasma. Okay. Now, because of that, he compares Durvasa to Sharadambodham, Tatitvantam Sharadambodham. Sharadrutu Ambodha Megha. Sharadrutu Megha Iva. Now, how is this Megha? The cloud that is there during autumn season is very white because it is after the rainy season. After the rainy season, you don't have any rain clouds, so the cloud is very white. Okay, so Sharadambodham, the Megha, and it will have, sometimes there will be a lightning once in a while, just a dry lightning probably. Okay, so now that lightning, along with that lightning, if you have a cloud, imagine that. So a white cloud with a lightning there. Now here, how does he compare it with Durvasa? Durvasa has a lot of bhasma on his body and he has Kopagni. We know that he is very, he always immediately gives shapa and his anger level is very high, right? Trigger point is very low, so he immediately gets angry. So Kopanalasya Jwala, he has a lot of kopa agni in his mind. Now, two, three adjectives are going to be with this. So, have that in mind. So, kopa analaha, the kopa agni that is there in his mind. Now, it comes out. The jata looks like the kopa agni jwala or the flames that come out. Now, how is it compared? Jata or the matted hair is reddish in color. His body is white because it is completely covered with bhasma. So he looks like the white autumn cloud, and the tatit or the saudamini, the lightning is reddish in color, right? A golden reddish in color. So the jwala of Agni will be golden color, right? Now the jata is the tatit here. So jata bihi tatitvantam abhibhavantam. It seems as if he is more lustrous than the cloud which has the lightning. Now, how do we connect it? Bhasita avakuntita sarvanga. He has covered his entire body with bhasita bhasma. Tadrisha bhasita sangena labdha parabhaga bhasurabhihi. Now, these jata have look more lustrous because of the bhasma that is there in his body. So, labdha parabhaga utkrishtam. Parabhaga means utkrishaha. Bhasurabhihi, it is more lustrous. So, he has applied bhasma. Then that adds to the luster that is there in the jata. Jatabhihi. All the tritiya bahuvachanam goes to jatabhihi here. Next, the jata is patala. It is red in color. Why? As if it looks like kopanalasya jwalabihi patalabihi iva. Jwalabihi iva patalabihi. It is the jata is like red, like the flames of the kopanala. Now, where is this kopanala coming from? Kopanala. Anila means kath, pavanam. Kopanala. It is bahir nirgamishyataha. Why? Because hridayam adhikataya abhivyapya. His hridaya is filled with this kopa agni, and there is no space there. So hridayam abhivyapya. It is as if his heart is completely, hridayam is completely enveloped or surrounded by this agni, and it doesn't have any space there. So it is bahir nirgachataha, nirgamishyataha. It is as if it is going to come out. The agni is going to come out. So you just find the flames on top. That is his jata. Imagine, bahir nirgamishyataha, not bahir nirgachataha. It is not as if the agni has come out and it is on top of him. There is still that agni there in his mind because he is going to give the shapam. So the agni has not totally come out of his mind. So hridayam adhikataya, hridayam abhivyapya, it is completely enveloping his mind. Adhikataya, because it is too much to handle. Bahir nirgamishyataha, it is as if it is trying to come out later. It will come out. Tadrisha kopanalasya jwalabihi iva jatabihi. Jatabihi, with this jata, he is trying to overshadow abhibhavantam. What does he overshadow? Tatitvantam. Tatitvantam. Abhinavam sharada ambodam. Ambaha dadati iti ambodaha megha. So sharadaha ambodaha sharatrutu ambodha megha. Abhinavam new. The megha is just come out, that cloud has just formed, so it is still white. There is no chance for it to have more water and become black. So it is still white. Tadrisham megham abhibhavantam iva, as if he is trying to overcome that or overshadow such a cloud. Okay, this is an adjective to Durvasa. Again, next adjective.
Apicha tribhuvanam anilo kavai
tribhuvana muniloka
tribhuvanam vailakshanya
పరికర్మిత లలాట మండలం త్రిపుండ్ర రేఖయా పరికర్మిత లలాట మండలం. he has that Shiva's three lines of vibhuti in his forehead, lalata mandalam, his forehead, parikarmita bhushita. It has it is alankrita, it is decorated with the tripundra rekha, the three lines of vibhuti. Now what does this, he imagines it to be like the fame. See, fame in Kavi Samaya, fame or kirti in Kavi Samaya is termed as white. Okay, if it is a good kirti, good fame, then it is white. If it is a bad fame, it is described as black. Okay, we are not being racist here, but that is the Kavi Samaya that is there. So kirtya eva, that tripundram looks like as if it represents the fame that Durvasa has. Now what is that fame that he has? Shapa moola tapo labha sambhavaya. Shapa moola tapo labha. This is a Purana reference. I don't know which Purana, but commentator Vyakhyata gives this shlokam where he says, Munehe durvasasaha anyatra tapo nashyati shapataha durvasasastu tapaha. Mune durvasasaha munehe anyatra. In other munis who are other than Durvasa, in the rishis who are other than Durvasa, their tapas nashyati, it destroys because of shapa. The moment you give a shapa, or the moment you, which means you're using your tapobalam, then your tapobalam goes down for other munis. Whereas here, Durvasasastu tapasaha vriddhihi ityahuhu astikaha. Apparently, Durvasa's tapobalam increases if he gives a shapa. It's a very different thing. Huh? So that is his kirti, that is his fame. Okay, so tribhuvana muniloka vailakshinya bodhinya shapamula tapolabha sambhavaya. Shapamula, his the tapolabha, he gets more of tapas, tapobalam, because of the shapa. So the shapa becomes the mula karanam for his tapolabha. Tadrisha tapolabha sambhavaya kirtya. It's an adjective for kirti. So he gets a fame. The fame he gets out of the tapo labam, which has its source for the shapa. Okay, now this kirti indicates that he is very different from the other phages, right? So, tribhuvana muniloka vailakshanya bodhinya. Tribhuvana, the three worlds, the muniloka, the sages that are there in the three worlds, he is very different from them. And this kirti, this fame, it's as if it is showing that bodhini, it is showing or indicating that he is very different from the other sages. Okay? Raghu, anything? I can't hear you properly. If there is anything, please write a question. Okay? No, mute panidre. So apicha tribhuvana muniloka vailakshanya bodhinya shapamoola tapolabha sambhavaya kirtya eva. This entire thing is the adjective. He compares it to that kirti. All of these two are the kirti adjective. It is not for the tripundra. So tripundra rekhaya parikarmita lalata mandalam. His forehead is alankrita. It is decorated by this tripundra rekha. Tripundra Rekha seems as if it is, it looks like the fame of Durvasa. Okay. Can we stop with this? Huh? Namaste. If you have any doubt, just end. Okay. Yeah. Dhanyavaad.